What if I told you there's a way to create and share custom maps in Google Maps, and you can do it in just a few minutes? Perfect for trip planning, mapping routes, and sharing your favorite city recommendations with friends. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share an alarming amount of Google content. This is how to create a custom map in Google Maps. First, let's head to Google My Maps at google.com/mymaps. And if you're not logged into your Google account already, you will be prompted to do so from here. Now you can see I already have some shared maps created here, but it's really easy to create your own custom shared Google map. To do so, click on Create New Map near the top, and you're going to get a little pop-out that says creating a My Maps map. We'll always upload title, thumbnail, and associated metadata to Drive. Click Create, and this will open up a new map. For me, a map of the US, because that's where I am. And now there are a couple of ways to create a custom map for any location, regardless of where you're at in the present moment. I find the quickest is to use the search bar at the top and just type in where you want to go. So I will type in Sydney, Australia, and it's gonna bring that map up. Now you can see here that it's plopped a marker for Sydney and it's added it here to the left. You can leave this here or you can hit the X. It really doesn't matter right yet. Our map is gonna stay on this city as long as we don't leave this page yet. But we do need to name this map up in the left. So click where it says Untitled Map and give it a title. So if you're planning a trip to Sydney, Australia, you could make that your title, just Sydney, Australia. You could say Sydney Trip, you could say 5 nights in Sydney. You get the idea, whatever makes sense for you. Then you can add a little description if you like, right underneath the title, and you'll click Save. And you can do these steps in reverse, by the way. So first you could have started by naming your map, so 5 nights in Sydney, and then we could have searched in the search bar for the city, your base location, if you will. It doesn't really matter the order here at this point. We can zoom in, we can use our mouse to move around the map, and here on the left under our base map, we can change this base map style. So if you want a satellite view, or maybe you want, I don't know, a simple atlas view, whatever you like, you can set it here. So this is how we've essentially created a base for our map. Now here's where things get fun. We still have this untitled layer here, which we can click to name it, either the city name or points of interest or restaurants or really any category you want, however you want to organize it. I'm going to name it points of interest because that's what works for me. You can name and rename this at any time, by the way, by clicking back into that layer name. Okay, so with this layer selected, using our hand tool, the mouse here, we can move around, zoom in on the map. We can find a place where we want to drop a pin on. So we can either click on it to add it to our map, or we can switch to the Add Marker option up underneath the search bar and click to drop the pin where we want it. Here, you can rename your marker to keep things organized. And you can do this for any place of interest, by the way. A restaurant, a museum, a garden, whatever. You can also add in a description, which is kind of nice. Maybe it's helpful notes you might need for your trip, though it's not required. When you're all done with that, click on Save. Now, to keep things even more organized, I recommend clicking the paint bucket and selecting an icon that best describes the location you're pinning. And you can change the color of the marker here too. I love this because I'm a visual learner. This is going to update that marker both on the map and in your layer on the left. You can even click the camera icon to add images to this marker. And you would do that by either uploading an image or you could even use Google search to find an image, which is pretty neat. Just make sure you click Save to save your changes. Now, because we've added a marker to this layer, our map is going to save as it is now. So this location in Sydney, you've got to have a layer with a marker set in order for your map to save it. That marker must be set. So now you can exit out of this view and head back into your maps and then click back into it and you can see it's opened right into our map of Sydney. But you can also use your search bar to find places you'd like to pin on the map. So rather than move the map around to find a spot, simply use that search bar to find what you need and a pin will automatically be dropped for you where you can click to add to map. Here you'd follow the exact same steps. You can click that paint bucket icon to set a custom pin for the marker. You can click edit to edit the name if needed. And if you need to move a pin on a map, like this Bondi Beach did not pop exactly at Bondi, simply click on the marker and drag it and drop it to the location. Now all you would do is repeat this process and repeat it again until you have all your points of interest labeled as you wish on your map. And you can add more layers to your custom map. So if you want to add a layer specifically for restaurants or tours or whatever it might be, you're going to click the Add Layer option in the left. This will add another untitled layer. Click on it to rename it. Again, you can name your layers for whatever organization works for you. It could be day one, day two, based on restaurants or themes, whatever it might be. And now, since we have more than one layer, when you want to add a marker to a specific layer, make sure you've clicked on it to select it. You will know it's selected because you'll see a blue line to the left. But say you do screw up and you add something to the wrong layer, all you have to do is drag it and drop it into the proper layer, and voila. What's nice about adding organized layers is that you can toggle off a layer if you don't want to focus on that during your travels, and then toggle it back on when you need it. But you can also import spreadsheet data to use as markers, so you don't have to add things manually individually each time. When you click to add a new layer, you're gonna have the option to import data from a CSV file, spreadsheet, or KML. So as an example here, I've created a simple Google sheet with a few tours and adventures we're gonna take in Sydney. I've got a column for the name and I've got a column for the address. In this case, it happens to be our meeting points for the tours. I'm gonna download this Google Sheet as a CSV file. Now, let's switch back to our custom map. Here, I'm gonna click on the import option under that untitled layer and add that CSV file. And here, you're gonna choose the columns from your file for where you want the place markers added. So I'm gonna click on address, then continue. And now we'll select the title of our markers. So for that, I'm going to choose the name I gave them in the column and click finish. And just like that, we've added multiple markers to our map in bulk. And you'll see our layer name even took on the name of the CSV file too, which of course we can click to clean up a bit if we want. And yes, you can customize your markers just like we learned how to do. So we've built a pretty good custom map so far, but believe it or not, we can customize it further by adding lines and directions and drawing shapes. This is so helpful. Under the search bar, click on Draw a Line, and let's first click on Add a Line or Shape. Then on our map, we simply have to click around where we want to add our shape, and we can close out the shape by clicking back on our first point. Now here, we're gonna name the shape, and we're gonna click Save, and it'll be added to the selected layer. From here, we can choose a color, and adjust the transparency of the color and make it stand out on the map even more by adding a border and adjusting the border thickness to the shape. This really helps things stand out on your custom map. Now you can also use the draw tool to draw routes, either walking, biking, or driving route. So let's click on driving route to add a route from our points of interest. We simply need to click our starting point and then click on the second stop. Then we're gonna head to the left and click add destination, and click on our third point in our destination. You'll notice not only has this created a driving route for us, but it's added that as a layer on our custom map. And you can click and drag your route to change it as well. This will add an additional anchor point. If you mess up, you can just double click that anchor point to remove it. By the way, you can also click on add directions at the top to add directions to your map as well in a similar way. So here you could simply type in your directions over on the left, or you could do it just like we showed where you'd click to add your start and end points. So once you have your entire map full of all of your layers and your points of interest and any directions you need, it's now time to share it. This is really so helpful for trip planning. Simply click that share icon from the left panel, and in this pop-up, you're gonna have a couple of options. First, you can toggle off the option for anyone with the link can view if you want just your own private map. But you can also toggle it to make it public to allow anyone to search for it and find your map. And this is the information they would see. It's your name and your profile pic. It's really up to you here in terms of privacy. If you click share on Drive, this will allow you to email it directly to your contacts or share it via a link. So you control the permissions here. First, I like to change this to anyone with a link so that I don't have to set individual permissions for people. And then if we click on copy link, I'm just gonna go here and hit done. And I will open up a new incognito window for us. Let me paste that link. And bam, here is that custom map we created. It's really that simple. Now, if we head back to google.com/mymaps, we can see all those maps I've created like we saw at the beginning of this video, but I can click into not owned or shared to see the maps others have shared with me. So a friend created a custom map for me when we were spending a few days in Paris. My cousin had created one with different neighborhoods when I was moving to Vancouver. But back in my owned maps, I've created maps to share with friends who are going to Vancouver, Sedona, Florence. You get the idea here. And you can share your map right from this page too. You would click on share map to share it to Facebook, Twitter, or via email, or even embed it into your own site. And by the way, clicking on the three-dot menu icon here will allow you to quickly open the map in a new tab, which is handy. You can copy the map or you can delete it altogether. What a great way to plan a trip and share the best things to do in any given city in such an interactive way. And yes, you can access My Maps on mobile as well, and there are a couple of ways to do so. You can literally just go to google.com/mymaps and you'll be able to use Google My Maps on mobile. Here you can access all of your maps, or you can tap the menu icon to create a map on the go. Or you could head to Google Maps, the actual app, tap on the U tab, scroll down and tap on Maps. Here you're gonna see all your maps where you can tap into one and view the legend, and then you could share that map from here too. Pretty neat. So now that you've created a custom map in Google Maps, all that's left to do is take the trip. So that's how to create a custom map in Google Maps using Google My Maps. And now I want to hear from you. Have you created any custom maps in Google Maps, and how have they helped you? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google Maps goodness. Thanks for watching. See you next time.